Hello and good afternoon, second grade class. Today I am going to be teaching you guys music, and we are going to be learning about musical eras. So the era that we are going to be learning about is medieval music. Can you guys say medieval music? Amazing. So to kind of start out, when you think of medieval music, a lot of times you think of castles and knights and going on quests and dragons, but a lot of times we don't really focus on the music that's come from it and how much it's impacted actually the music we have today. So before we begin, we are going to talk a little bit about some of the instruments that are used in the music. So I'm going to play you a bit of a sound of an instrument, and I want you to guys try and guess what it is. So we're going to be doing a little bit of a guessing game. So how it's going to work, I'm going to play the sound, and if you know what it is, give a thumbs up. If you don't know what it is, give a thumbs down. And then I will pick, and we will try to guess who can name the instrument. So here is the first one. Okay, I see a couple thumbs ups. Alrighty, can I have someone try to tell me what they think it is? You are right, it is a flute. So a flute is something that they used a lot back then in terms of their music. Oh, it's actually really funny about the flute that they use is it actually looks a lot like the recorders that we use in music today. So here is a picture of the flute. I will turn it around and I will show you. That is what it would look like. Amazing. So, sorry, that was a little bit of a rough transition. The second instrument that I'm going to play is a little bit harder to guess. I'm going to see if not necessarily you guys can guess the name of it, but an instrument that it sounds like. So here it is. Yeah, what does it sound like? Do you think it's a wind instrument, or do we think it is a string instrument? You're right, it is a string instrument. This instrument is called a dulcimer. Can you guys say dulcimer? Amazing. So something that is very distinct about this instrument is that it looks a little bit like a guitar, but it's actually played sitting on your lap face down, just like this. So I'm gonna show you a picture of somebody playing it. And that is what it would look like. So they play it sitting down on their lap. And it's a big piece in the hands of their music. And here is the last instrument that we're going to talk about. So what kind of instrument do you guys think this is? Percussion, string. You're right, it is a string instrument, and it's called a lyra. Can you guys say a lyra? So a lyra is played, it looks almost like a violin, but it's played on your knee. So it's held on your knee and you play it like this. Can you guys make that motion for me? Amazing. So those are three types of instruments that were used in the medieval era. So can you guys say flute, dulcimer, and a lyra? So now that we kind of know a little bit about the instruments, I'm going to give you guys some information about the medieval era. So the medieval era was one of the longest eras in history. It's also known as the Middle Ages. How many of you guys have heard about the Middle Ages? Anybody seen any movies about the Middle Ages? What's something that you've noticed in the movies? Yeah, there's a lot of castles. What's something else? Princes and princesses. When they have music, is it very upbeat music and everybody's dancing? Yes, that is very distinct. So it took place from the 5th to the 16th century. So that is a lot of years. It is the longest period of music and runs around the time of the fall of the Western Roman Empire to the beginning of the Renaissance era, which is a whole nother style of music. It is very, very important to the Catholic Church. So the reason why it was so important to the Catholic Church is because they wanted to standardize what people sung in churches across the Western world. So as the church, they wanted to say, we want to know what everybody sings, so everybody sings the same. So something that is very distinct in Renaissance music is there are two main categories. So there is the monophonic, can you guys say that after me? And the polyphonic. So monophonic, does anybody know what mono means? Is it one or many? So it stands for one sound. So it's only a single melody line. And something that is very distinct about the monophonic sound is something called the Gregorian chant. So the Gregorian chant is a single line of vocal melody. So it's unaccompanied and it's free rhythm. So it's you kind of just sing your line and you don't really have any structure of music behind it. It's only led by your voice. It is the most common form of medieval music. It's sung at mass in commemoration and celebration of the Last Supper. So it's very important whenever there is a church service, you always had the singing of the Gregorian chant. It wasn't really something that you would sing along with, but that people would sing over you. It was almost like their version of a prayer. And its text form would be called the liturgy. So system of modes is characteristic of the medieval period. So I am just going to pull up that video and we are going to hear a little bit about what this might sound like. So I want you guys, I'm going to play it and we're going to listen to a little bit once and then I'm going to play it again and you guys are going to tell me a little bit about what you're hearing. What are some things that you're hearing? So something that I kind of was in the characteristic is everybody is singing the same notes. So there's no harmonies, there's no instruments, it's just voices. And this was often sung over the church and it was sung as a choir. So not necessarily one person would sing it, but it would be sung over the people. Or it would be a call and response. One person would say a line. And then everybody would respond after it. So that is an example of a monophonic sound. Polyphonic, which is many sounds. So it has more than one melody line played at the same time. It's a major shift, and this was commonly seen towards the end of the medieval era and laid the foundations for the Renaissance style of music. So there are two, or actually there's one main type, and it's called the organum. So it's two lines of voices, and there are three main types. There's parallel, free, and melismatic. So parallel is one voice sings melody while the others sing in a fixed interval in a fixed way. So I'm going to play what that would sound like. So now you see a lot of voices are coming in. So that is what you would call a parallel organum. The second type is the free organum. So I'm going to play a video and then I want you guys to tell me the difference of it. So what's something that you notice? So something that's a big difference is that everybody in this type are singing the same thing, but at different rates, at different times. So it's more like a round. Remember when we sang Row, Row, Row Your Boat and I had all of you guys in different sections and you would start at different times? That's more what the free organum would sound like. And the last one is the melismatic. So this is the accompanying part stays on the single note while the other parts move around. So this is what that would sound like. So you see how one voice is going above and around what everybody else is doing. So those are the three main types. So right now what we're going to do is I am going to play a piece of music and I want you guys to first determine if it's a monophonic or polyphonic. The second is I want you to try to find the beat. And then the third one is I want you to try and figure out what was different about it. So I'm going to play the music and then you guys will break off into your groups. Alrighty, so based on what we worked on, so that is something that you guys are going to do. And then also what I'm going to have you guys break off and do is one of the most common forms of doing music is making a ballad. So a ballad is kind of like a poem. So troubadours and trovers were traveler singers and performers, and they would come, and the most common form of this would be Christmas carols. So what you guys are going to do is you guys are going to write a ballad together. So it means just a simple and short poem. They can be sung, they cannot be sung, you can speak them out, but you each are going to perform it in class next period. So I have the steps up here of what you guys are going to do with your ballad. So the first time is you're going to find a subject, then rhyming words, then turn it into a sentence, have a couple stanzas, and then choose a familiar melody. So like I said, very common was Christmas carol, so I would consider doing a Christmas carol form of it. And yeah, that is all.